Good day, everyone. Good day, Pastor Ernest.
Hi, Pastor Rodel. Mabuti, mabuti.
Kumusta naman ang iyong asawa, si Kim and si Amaris?
Yeah, they're doing very well and they're doing homeschool and also they're looking forward for the Christmas vacation and the holidays.
Wow.
How about you, Pastor Del? Kumusta naman si Miss Olive and si Sophie, your daughter?
Well, actually, they're also doing okay. And si Sophie, ever since, homeschool talaga siya.
Okay.
And they're talagang na-enjoy namin yung time namin together.
That's good.
Yes. And also, I just wanna greet every one of you.
Hello, welcome.
Welcome here in our Pre-Service Usapan. So again, here with me, one of our heroes in the field. Pastor. One of the missionaries been working in the field for many years now, Pastor Ernest.
Okay, thank you, Pastor Rodel. And also, thank you for joining us. Thank you for taking time to join us in our online worship services.
Now, we are here in our online worship service. You know, I just want to highlight, not the... speaking of... online worship service, Pastor Ernest. Alam mo ba na hanggang ngayon, 3 months na tayong nag-onsite.
Yes, so, and that's
may,
good.
Yeah, may online tayo, pero may onsite tayo.
Yes.
And speaking of online, you know, talagang napaka, God really created each one of us to be in community. So,
yes.
I'm also okay with the online, but mas iba talaga ang feeling pag nasa onsite tayo.
Amen.
Ano ba, Pastor Ernest, ikaw, what can you say about online, on-site service?
Well, unang-una, the church is called the gathered ones and the gathered church. You know? So that's why we really have to gather together. There was a time talaga na we cannot, but praise God, and now, inaalaw na po tayo. And truly, na-miss ko po talaga yung makasama kayo physically. Though may distancing naman, iba pa rin po talaga yung worshiping God together and studying the Word together, no, Pastor Rodel?
Yes, I agree with that, Pastor Ernest. And also, I just want to remind everyone,
the church
is very the place wherein safest place to go with.
Yep.
And also, just want to encourage every one of you, kung hindi pa po kayo nakaka-attend ng ating on-site worship service, we'd like to invite you. It's open for 18 years old to 65 years old.
Please come.
So, please join us Sunday after Sunday. We have 11 a.m., we have 1 p.m., also
and
3 p.m.
Yes. Also, Pastor Rodel, we would like to invite you, for our Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve online worship services. And that would be on December 24 and December 31. Online po ito, no? And make this bago po tayo mag-celebrate as a family before we can have a feast or have a dinner together. Let's worship God together po, no? Let's all be reminded that we are celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Pastor Del?
Yes, I agree with that. Again, you know, we make it really special itong event, dalawang events.
Amen. That's good.
Okay, so again, exciting po yon. Please wait for that, attend and join us in that two event that we have. Siyempre bago matapos ang taon, we would like to invite our people, every one of you as well, to attend our annual prayer and fasting.
Yeah,
so
yes.
Pastor Ernest,
exciting
magsisimula yan.
Yes.
Magsisimula yan ng January 11 hanggang January 15. So that would be on Monday hanggang Friday.
Yes.
So after feasting na
fasting naman.
ng Christmas Eve, ng New Year's Eve, now fasting.
Fasting naman. It's also a good time for us to start the year seeking God and seeking His face for our lives and for our families. And if you are a Victory Group leader, please save the date. We will have our first Leaders Convergence on January 9, 4 p.m. po yan. And that's a Saturday. So ngayon pa lang, paki-mark na po yung inyong mga calendars kasi pagkatapos ng holiday, mabilis na po yan. So maganda po, maalala na po natin yan. Pastor Dan?
Nice. Thank you for that, Pastor Ernest. And also, we have prepared something for all the volunteers. So we will be having a Pastors and Volunteers Huddle Online. So that would be on January 16, 8 p.m. So please, again, mark your calendar.
Well, I hope you enjoyed our pre-service usapan, you know, and we will be starting our service soon and in a while. And please do prepare your hearts as we worship God together. So everyone, Pastor Del,
see you!
Merry Christmas, everyone. Welcome to Victory Antipolo. This is our Sunday worship service online. My name is Ernest, and I am your missionary to a restricted nation in Southeast Asia. And if this is your first time to join us, we would like to welcome you. Welcome na welcome po kayo to join us. And we are so glad that you could have joined us today. We are available both on Facebook and on YouTube. You can click the share button, tag your friends, your family members, and your friends' victory groups in the comment section. If you believe, meron ka pang kakilala, kasama, kaibigan na hindi pa nakakakilala sa Panginoon, gusto mo mag-worship sa kanila sa Panginoon, kasama ka, please do share this video. We are Victory. We are here to honor God and make disciples. We are here as one church in Metro Manila, meeting and doing online services in different locations. And I would like to invite every one of us, wherever you are, to join us in a time of singing and worshiping our God. Let me pray. Father in heaven, thank you for this wonderful day that you have given to us. Truly, Father God, hope has come for us, Lord. Dahil dumating na ang aming tagapagligtas na si Jesu Cristo. And right now, Lord, we are submitting our hearts to you. We are submitting our crowns. We are submitting everything of us, Lord, as we worship you, as we sing praises to you, Panginoon, dahil ikaw lang ang tunay na Diyos na tapat at dakila at dapat sambahin. Maraming salamat po, Panginoon. Lord, we pray that everything that we will do today will be glorifying to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone say, amen and amen. Let's worship God.
To our God. Jesus be sung, for a king has come, let all the earth sing, for our God and King. Let praises be sung, for our Savior reigns, and every knee will bow, for our God and King. From the heights of the heavens to the depths of the sea,
Powerful King, the great King, who have decided to come here on earth, humble himself down so that he could be with his creation, us people. Lord, thank you for coming to earth, for saving us, for dying for our sins, for forgiving us. And Lord, we cannot say thank you enough and appreciate you so much for what you have done. You are the greatest King. You are the King of Kings. And yet, you said, I want to go down to save my people. And with that, Lord, thank you very much, Lord. Maraming maraming salamat, Lord. Though marami kaming pinagdaraanan, Lord, marami kaming di maintindihan for the past 12 months, Lord. But still, Father God, you are the King of Kings and you are still in control. You are still on the throne. You are still God. You know what you are doing. Lord, we thank you because hindi ka nagkakamali. Kailan man, Panginoon, wala kang desisyon na nagkamali ka, Panginoon. And we trust in your wisdom. We trust in what you are doing in our lives, in our families, and in our nation. I pray for your people right now, those who are hopeless and those who are praying, Lord, na hindi pa dumarating. In Jesus' name I pray, continue to speak hope to them. Continue to speak faith for them, Lord. I pray, Lord, that faith would arise in their midst and in their families. Be with them right now. Comfort them. Give them peace that transcends all understanding. Thank you, Father, for this time that we could worship you, that we could gather together even though online, Lord. Makakasama kami, Panginoon. Alam namin, Lord, nakasama mo kami, Holy Spirit, worshiping you and singing praises to you, Lord. Maraming maraming salamat po for this church. Maraming maraming salamat po dahil we have this community who we can always run to, Panginoon. Maraming maraming salamat po. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. And maraming maraming salamat po for joining us in our online worship service. Again, we are Victory, and we are here to honor God and to make disciples. My name is Ernest. I am your missionary to a restricted nation in Southeast Asia. And ako po personally ay nagagalak na kayo po ay taking time, you're taking time to watch this and worship God with us as a church. And you know, 2020 is really unlike any other year. Ito pong dinanas natin for the past 12 months, once in a generation event lang po ito. But despite all the unforeseen challenges and uncertainties that we have faced, God came through for us and showed an amazing grace all throughout the year. And nakakatuwa po, that's how we started the year. Amazing grace when we had our prayer and fasting. And until today, God's amazing grace is still with us. We are thankful. Ako po personally, nagpapasalamat po ako for all the miracles that He has done. And as a church also, we are thankful for all the miracles that He has done for us, in us, and for us, and each and every one of you. Thank you very much for your dedication to reach the campus, plant churches, and reach the nations for Jesus Christ. And with that, I'd just like to introduce to you this video, a short update of what has happened for all the past 12 months. Let's watch this.
When the pandemic struck the Philippines in March, thousands of students were stranded without much necessary supplies. Seeing this challenge, our campus missionaries and leaders looked for ways to meet their needs. We gathered resources and partnered with the schools. Little did we know, our small acts of service would open opportunities we never had before. At the University of the Philippines in Los Baños, our campus ministry volunteered to deliver food to stranded students, since many were unwilling to leave because of fear of being infected. Through the partnership with the university, we served and encouraged over 1,000 freshman students in dorms and more than 700 upper-class students outside the campus. Because of this, we were also given the privilege of being the only external organization to assist in holding welcoming events for the freshmen this school year. These efforts led to more students joining our church and small groups online. We were also able to distribute around 800 laptops and give health insurance to deserving senior high school students and college scholars through the Real Life Foundation. Discipleship also continues to grow across our campus ministries. Because of limitations in physical gatherings, we took our youth services and discipleship meetings and outreach events online. When students don't have access to the internet, our campus missionaries reach out to them through other ways, like SMS and phone calls. Campuses are still being reached. In fact, a principal in a school in Santa Cruz, Laguna, now holds victory groups with all 60 of her teachers. Together, we continue to reach the next generation.
We also did not stop declaring and demonstrating the gospel to cities. When our newly planted church in Lemery, Batangas was devastated by the Taal volcano's eruption, Pastor Ferdy Fabul and our leaders didn't allow their circumstances to hinder them from serving and bringing hope to others. They rescued people, visited households, gave relief packs donated by our churches, and ministered to families. Now, our church in Lemery continues to multiply in numbers despite the pandemic because of the strong sense of community. Generosity and service in the church also continue to touch people's lives. We initiated relief efforts across the Philippines called #GoodNews2020 to bless medical workers, policemen, jeepney drivers, impoverished communities, and other people in need. The Every Nation building became a temporary housing facility for frontliners from March to May. And our churches in Lipa and Pasig also opened their buildings for the same use. When typhoons struck our nation, we helped and partnered with the most affected areas through #TyphoonPHRelief. We are grateful to church members who also led and initiated efforts. In Victory Nova, Victory Group leaders volunteered to drive for more than 10 hours to send over 700 relief packs to our church in Cagayan. Our churches in Bulacan also prepared relief packs, and pastors and members drove in trucks and motorcycles to Naga and Cagayan. Leaders in Victory Metro East donated sacks of rice and goods to DSWD as well. And they took the opportunity to pray for the DSWD office and the mayor of Marikina. In the face of a crisis, we continue to pray for our government leaders and find ways to serve our nation.
Church planting also doesn't stop. When the pandemic came, worship services and discipleship never ended. All our churches and pastors were ready to shift activities online. Even with many restrictions, we engage, establish, equip, and empower people. Many are getting saved and baptized even now. In some provinces and congregations in Metro Manila, the number of people in victory groups and discipleship classes doubled. This is unprecedented growth. Despite communication and transportation barriers, the mission continues. By God's grace, we were able to start 4 new churches in Asia, 3 of which were planted by local leaders. Many doors for the gospel also opened. So we now have 14 ongoing church plants across the Philippines. We did not stop meeting together too. Before the year ended, we started to resume on-site services while following health and safety protocols. We are now preparing to open our facilities and worship in all our locations soon. These are all displays of God's amazing grace in our church. No crisis could ever stop His purposes and promises.
Because of God's amazing grace, we got to be the salt and light even in these dark times. Thank you for your faith and generosity in spite of your own personal challenges. As we look forward to 2021, we can be assured that the church can be an unstoppable source of hope to this world because we have an awesome God. Together, in every situation, let's continue to honor God and make disciples.
We can always count on God's faithfulness even in the midst of difficulties and circumstances. As we enter 2021, let us fix our eyes on our awesome God and be excited and be expectant to experience more of His greatness and His goodness in our lives every day. Together, let's continue to honor God and to make disciples. All right, now in our time of giving, let me read from 2 Chronicles chapter 31, verses 11, 12, and then we will skip to verse 21. And I am reading from the New King James Version. Verse 11, let's read. Now Hezekiah commanded them to prepare rooms in the house of the Lord, and they prepared them. Then they faithfully brought in the offerings, the tithes, and the dedicated things. Konaniah, the Levite, had charge of them, and Shimei, his brother, was the next. And in every work that he began in the service of the house of God, in the law and in the commandment, to seek his God, he did it with all his heart. So he prospered. Amen. I would like to highlight two words here, faithfully and seek. Do you know that as we give faithfully and as we continue to seek God, it is the Lord God who will make us prosperous and successful in everything we do. Thank God for the skill that he has given to us. Thank God for the intelligence, to the hands that we have right now. But eventually, ultimately, it is God who make things grow. And I like from the verse that we have read that it's also, they did it with all of his heart. And that's my prayer for all of us, that as we give faithfully and seek God faithfully, we will do it with all of our hearts. Amen po ba? Now let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you because you have given us the ability to produce wealth. Maraming salamat, Ama, sa aming mga trabaho, sa aming mga kakayanan, sa aming talino, sa aming mga abilities, Panginoon. Maraming salamat for the opportunities that you have given us as well, Panginoon, para kaming kumita, magkaroon ng revenue, para maging blessing sa aming mga family, sa aming mga friends. And Lord, right now as we give, we pray that in Jesus' name you would use these gifts for the advancement of your kingdom here in our city. Lord, I pray for the people who is giving today. May you bless them all the more as they continually and faithfully give, Panginoon. Maraming salamat sa mga taong ito. And I pray, Lord, that you would just multiply whatever it is that they have given. Maraming salamat po. Ito po ang aming dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen at amen. You know, giving is an act of worship, whether we do it physically or online. Just a few reminders. You may give your tithes online using your credit card, debit card, or through your GCash. Kindly visit our website at victory.org.ph/give. But if you still prefer to give through the offering envelopes, you may drop them at our tithes boxes in our Victory Antipolo Center every Sunday at 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And at the same time, hindi pa po yan, meron pa po. There is also a contactless giving option using a credit card terminal. You may approach one of our admin staff as you want to do this option. So maraming salamat po. Smile as you give, and I pray that God will speak to you as we preach and as we study the word after this. God bless you.
Hi everyone, good day sa bawat isa. So welcome to our online worship service. And if this is your first time to join us, would like to welcome you. Again, this is Victory and we are here for two reasons. That is to honor God and make disciples. By the way, I am Rodel and I'm one of the pastors here in Victory Antipolo. And today we will be concluding our series na In Time. Sino ba sa inyo na subaybayan niyo yung dalawang unang topics natin, and we talk about Jesus as the Logos or the Lord of our lives, and last week we discuss about Jesus as life, the giver of life. And today we will be talking about Jesus as the light. Okay? So pag-usapan po natin 'yan later on. And who among you will agree with me that many of us are hoping for better days in time, but as believers of Christ, followers of Christ, we know that our hope is in Christ, and He came in time to bring hope and light. So my prayer para sa ating lahat, na ang lahat tayo ay maintindihan natin na more than a baby in a manger, Jesus is Lord, He is the Creator, He is preeminent, He is sovereign. in our lives, and also the source of all life, light for us these troubled times now we are facing. Okay, so some of us maaring may pinagdadaanan ngayon na we're thinking na yung Christmas natin is like parang mahirap i-celebrate, but my encouragement again is that each one of us would be able to celebrate this Christmas because Jesus is the source of life and light. So our response as believers to be witnesses of this light, of His light, in order that many may believe or encounter, have a personal relationship with our Lord. So I'd like to read in John chapter 1. So we'll be beginning in verse 1. So we have a few verses to read. So in verse 1, it says here, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." Let's jump in verse 9. "The true light which gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through Him, yet the world did not know Him. He came to His own, and His own people did not receive Him. But to all who did receive Him, who believed in His name, He gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God." In verse 14, "And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." Let us pray. Lord, we thank You for Your Word. We thank You that Your Word brings assurance, bring comfort, bring wisdom, bring enlightenment sa bawat isa sa amin. And we pray that even as we study Your Word, we ask that Your Holy Spirit will be in our own homes, Lord, in our own house, that Your presence will be felt. We honor You, God. Bless the preaching of Your Word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. All right. Now, I just want to give you a quick background about the text that we've read. But basically, while I'm studying the book of John, I'm searching talaga kung ano yung pinaka-background ng book of John. And maraming mga details about it, pero hindi talaga nagbigay ng concrete explanation. Okay, kung ano yung situation ng pagkakasulat ng book of John. But I just want to give you this intro. We can see it in Luke chapter 2, verse 1, the nation of Israel under the Roman Empire, which is Caesar Augustus, issued a decree to have a census for the entire nation. So basically, yung bansa ng Israel ay sobrang busy during this time. And the people are doing their own thing. Okay, sobrang busy nila. Sila Joseph and Mary just went to their hometown para magpa-register. Okay, ito yung time na kung saan nagsimula na yung mga taxes para magkaroon ng tax sila. Okay, so parang sobrang busy. Ako po, na-experience ko po yung sobrang naghihintay ako at nag-search ako kung saan maganda kumuha ng easy trip. Alam niyo ba yun? Yung para makabiyahe ka sa S-Lex, sa N-Lex. Ang haba-haba ng pila. And during this time, ganun yung nangyayari sa kanila. No? Sobrang haba ng pila and inabot na sa panganganak ni Mary. So sobrang haba ng, sobrang siguro daming tao. And guess what? There is no place for Mary to give birth to Jesus in Luke chapter 2, verse 7. So ito yung nangyari sa kanila. No? Talagang that's why pinanganak si Jesus sa sabsaban kaysa manger. Now, in John chapter 1, verse 9, "The true light which gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through Him. Yet the world did not know Him. He came to His own, and His own people did not receive Him." Okay? Now, my question is, why the people failed to recognize the one who created the world? Okay, the one who created the world. So again, maraming dahilan, but maraming reasons. But first is, maaaring busy sa family. Okay, during this time, Israel kasi ay talagang naghihintay sila ng Savior nila. Okay, ng Messiah na magsisave sa kanila. But during this time, dumating na si Jesus, they failed to recognize Him. Maybe sa atin, di ba, during that time, na ngayon, parating na yung Pasko, pero hindi natin nararamdaman, maaaring busy tayo sa family. Or maaaring busy tayo sa business natin. Or maaaring sa trabaho natin. We are into it. Talagang sobrang busy natin. At hindi natin nararamdaman na Christmas na pala. Or maaaring yung mga estudyante, busy sa pag-aaral. Sobrang studious. Di ba mga students? Yes. Alright. Or iba naman sa atin, why maaaring yung during the time ng pagdating ni Jesus, no? Yung mga, actually, yung, again, yung Israel are really, they are preoccupied. Kaya hindi nila nakita si Jesus. Or hindi nila naramdaman yung pagdating ni Jesus. Or sa atin, maaaring you are preoccupied during at this time. Or they are not expectant. Or maybe you are expecting for something. Different Savior, or they are expecting somebody else na hindi ipapanganak sa sabsaban. You know, two nights ago, meron pong dumating sa place namin, and hindi ko po ini-expect, no, yung not expectant, hindi ko po ini-expect na may darating sa amin. And nung nakita ko sila, okay lang, parang I didn't say hi to them. Okay, sobrang rude ko, no? Dumating sa bahay at hindi ako nag-hi sa kanila. And good thing sila yung nag-hi sa akin. Hi, sabi nila sa akin. So, doon the time na realize, oh nga, no, ba't hindi ako nag-say hi sa kanila? And right there, I just say sorry to God, Lord, sorry, hindi ko sila pinansin. And maraming reason, ano, why people fail to recognize the one who created the world. Or, sa atin, may mga kakilala tayo na hindi pa talaga nakakilala sa Panginoon. Or maybe at this season, hopeless talaga, hopelessness. We fail to recognize. Or maaari naman na despite of this pandemic that we are facing, despite of health issue, pinagpapala tayo ng Panginoon. Yun naman yung abundance that can hinder us from recognizing who Jesus is in our lives. Or the last one is, maybe you are in bondage or we are in bondage of sin. Okay? Kaya lumalayo tayo. Hindi natin ina-acknowledge kung sino si Jesus. But in John 20:31, we can see that, but these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in His name. Life in His name. Now, Jesus the light. Jesus the light, and this is what we're going to talk about, that Jesus as the light of man, and the significance of this light in today's reality. Ano nga ba yung importansya nito? Ano ba nga ba ang makikita natin? And we all know that the creator of light is God. God is the creator of life, and or light, and He is the source of light. Okay, you know, in the Bible, light can be described as natural. Okay, ano ba yung natural light? Yung sun, okay? Kita natin yan, yung sun, yung moon, yung stars, those are natural. And minsan naman, makikita natin, di ba, artificial. Ano ba yung mga artificial? Yun yung lamps, ito yung nakikita natin, mga ilaw. Okay, artificial light yan. And meron namang miraculous or extraordinary light. Okay? Nasaan yun? Makikita natin sa Bible. During that time, okay, miraculous because during that time, God formed a cloud to protect the nation of Israel from the sun. Okay? Pillar of cloud by day para hindi sila masunog. And pillar of fire by night. Para meron silang liwanag. So, amazing, extraordinary, miraculous performance by our God. Okay? Now, this is what we're going to do, to discuss is that three truths of Jesus as light in our lives. Miraculously, miracles of Jesus na ginawa sa buhay ng bawat isa sa atin. Ano nga ba ang matututunan natin dito? Okay? Now, the first one is, Jesus is the light of men. Ilaw siya ng buhay ng bawat isa sa atin. Ng buhay mo, ng buhay ko. Meaning, pag si Jesus ang nagbigay ng liwanag sa buhay natin, it will expose the real you. It will expose the real you. Makikita. Makikita mo kung sino talaga yung pagkatao mo. Kung sino talaga si Rodel. Kung sino talaga, kung may nanonood na Michael, kung may nanonood na Susan, kung may nanonood na Joy, kung may nanonood na Jericho, kung may nanonood na Beth, makikita mo talaga kung sino si Jesus. Or ipapakita ni Jesus kung sino ka talaga sa pagkatao mo. Now, in verse 4 chapter 1 ng John, it says there, in Him was life, and the life was the light of men. In Him was life. Si Jesus came here on earth, and that life became the light of each one of us. Now, in John chapter 8, verse 12, again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but have the light of men. Have the light of men. I mean, talaga magiging ilaw tayo sa paligid natin. So, yun yung ginawa ni Jesus sa buhay natin. Okay, it exposes the real you. One of the best illustration is when this woman actually caught in adultery and brought in the feet of Jesus. Okay, in front of Jesus. And sinabi ng mga tao sa paligid na, this woman is caught in adultery. Sabi sa law na pag nahuli ka, na nangangalun niya, okay, kailangan daw batuhin. And Jesus just bent his knees and wrote on the ground. Okay, and actually sinabi ni Jesus, okay, kung sino man sa inyo ang walang kasalanan, sila yung unang-unang babato sa babae na to. And si Jesus nagsulat lang sa ground. Okay? Not minding the people. Tapos nung umano siya, tumingin siya sa babae, wala bang bumato sa iyo? Sabi ng babae sa kanya, wala po. Okay? So walang bumato sa kanya. So ang sinabi ni Jesus, neither will I condemn you. So ganun si Jesus, it exposes the sin, pero hindi tayo kino-condemn ng ating Panginoon. Okay, and lahat ng nasa paligid ni Jesus, lahat makasalanan. So ganun, pag pumasok ang ilaw or pumasok si Jesus sa buhay natin as life and became the light of our lives, it will expose sin in our lives. It's just a matter of humbling before the Lord or covering it and running away from Him. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 17 to 24, this is a kind of medyo mahabang text. No? Now this I say that and testify in the Lord that you may no longer walk as the Gentiles do. So, Paul is telling to the Ephesians na don't live a life just like the Gentiles. Tayo daw. Actually, yung Gentiles na sinasabi dito ay tayo yun. Okay? In the futility of their minds, they are darkened in their understanding, alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them. Due to their hardness of heart. So, again, people rejecting the very word of God because of their heart. In verse 19, they have become callous and have given themselves up to sensuality, greedy, and to practice every kind of impurity. But that is not the way you learn Christ. So, hindi raw ganun yung buhay natin. Ngayon na nakay Kristo na tayo, hindi na ganun yung ipinapamuhay natin. Okay, pinakita na, in-expose na yun ni Lord. It's just about really living out the light that God has given to us. In verse 21, assuming that you have heard about Him and were taught in Him as the truth is in Jesus, to put off your old self which belonged to your former manner of life and is corrupt through deceitful desires. In verse 23, and to be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and to put on the new self created after the likeness of God through righteousness and holiness. So again, as God exposes the real us, which is yung mga bagay na hindi pleasing sa Panginoon, hindi honoring sa kay Lord, and now we are given to really the opportunity to live according to the purposes of our God, which is that led me to my second point. Jesus cannot be overcome by darkness. Ano ba ibig sabihin nito? If Jesus cannot overcome by darkness, therefore, it enables us to live a righteous life. It will enable you and me to live a righteous life. Aren't you glad that God, that Jesus, as He continued to be the life and light in our lives, you can live a righteous life. I can live a righteous life. We can live a righteous life. Now in John chapter 1, verse 5, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Okay, Jesus cannot be overcome by darkness. So, ano ba sa atin yun? Okay, it brings confidence. It brings security sa atin. Na yung trust natin kay Lord, mas lalong tumitibay, mas lalong tumitindi. Now, in John 12, verse 46, I have come as a light to shine in this dark world so that all who put their trust in me will no longer remain in the dark. As you continue to trust the Lord, okay, as you continue to live out your faith before the Lord, okay, just want to let you know that the God that we're serving, the Lord that we're serving, cannot be overcome by darkness. Ganun din sa atin. We can overcome darkness. We can live a righteous and holy life. Okay? We can live a righteous and holy life. Parang kagaya ng ano, ng itong kandila na to, no? Diba? So, yung kandila or yung light, dapat syempre na-expose siya sa paligid natin. Okay? It brings light. It brings actually clarity. So, minsan, itong kandila na to, minsan pilit na pinapatay. Diba? Pilit na hinihipan, in a sense. So, minsan, syempre, sa sobrang lakas ng hangin, maaaring na-experience natin, okay, minsan namamatay yung ilaw. Okay, namamatay yung ilaw. For example, kagaya nito. Yan, namatay na. Okay? So, ang alam nyo ba na ang life natin is parang kagaya ng kandila na to. Kung hindi ito attached kay Jesus, okay, mamamatay talaga at mamamatay yung kandila or yung ilaw natin. So that's why it's always keep yourself in following the Lord, in living in the light of God through Jesus Christ. And just wanna encourage us na yung light na yon cannot be overcome by darkness. Parang kagaya ng ilaw na to. Nakikita nyo ba itong ilaw na to? Ito, kahit anong ihip mo dyan, kahit anong gawin mo dyan, kahit anong lagyan mo na pinakamalakas na electric fan, yung ilaw na yan, hindi siya mamamatay. Okay, hindi siya mamamatay. Kasi si Jesus ay kagaya ng ilaw na yan. Hindi siya mamamatay. And you know, during the time na si Jesus is ipanganak, the devil is just working double time para mamatay yung Savior na to. Okay? So during the time nung Herod, the people commanded, actually yung mga sundalo nila commanded na patayin lahat ng bata. Okay? Para walang magpalit na maging hari na kagaya niya or pumalit sa kanya. During that time, and papanganak pa lang si Jesus, walang in na pwedeng manganak si Mary. So again, the devil is trying to work hard to kill Jesus. Even that time, nasa right time na, to the point that Jesus surrendered to the very will of the Father to die on the cross for us. But even after dying on that cross, He rose again from the grave and proving that He is the Son of God and offering the gift of salvation to those who believe in Him and repents and receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And even death cannot stop the light of Jesus. Now, as you continue to trust the Lord, then God has given us the ability to live yung buhay natin nakaaya-aya sa Panginoon. Now in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 8 it says here, for at the one time you were darkness but now you are light in the Lord, walk as children of light. So meaning God has given us the ability to walk into the path that God has showed us. Na si Jesus ang nagiging guide sa atin. Now, the third point is Jesus uses us to be light to others. Jesus uses us to be a light to others. Ano ba ibig sabihin nito? It encourages us to share the gospel to those people around us. You know, isa ito sa pinaka maganda na ginagawa natin. How can we be an encouragement? Or how can we share the gospel to those people around us? Okay, and how can your light shine brighter? Paano ba natin maipakita yun sa tao sa paligid natin? Definitely by demonstration. It is by demonstration. Why? Because we want to preach the gospel to them. Okay, it encourages us to share the gospel. Now, and you know, marami po tayong mga ginagawa na dito sa Victory Antipolo, no? Nagkaroon po tayo ng Acts 4. Ito po yung time na kung saan we really help those people around us. Okay, na to bless. Actually, before we show the slide to you, no? Let me read this verse. Let me read this verse in Matthew 5:14-16. It says here, "You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house." So, you know, ikinumpara tayo na tayo rin daw ay ilaw sa paligid natin. Now, in verse 16, we can read here, "In the same way, let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and give glory to the Father who is in heaven." So that they may see your good works. Paano ba talaga maging Kristiyano? Paano ba talaga maging ilaw na yung ilaw natin nag talagang mas lalong lumiwanag? It is by demonstration. Pinapakita natin. Like say for example, you know, meron pa akong kilala no na tinawagan siya ng isang kaibigan niya na nag-positive yung silang mag-asawa. And itong tao na to, no, nakakilala ko, talagang out from his pocket, nag-send ng support sa mag-asawa na to. Okay, so you can make your light shine even brighter by helping them. Okay, by giving generously. So ito po yung Ask for initiatives natin dito sa Antipolo. Marami po tayong kakilala na nagkaroon ng COVID. You know, ang ginawa natin, actually ito yung mga hindi ito initiated ng church but leaders from our church did this. Sila yung gumawa nito and sumama lang, sinamahan namin sila in doing this. Namigay tayo ng mga vitamin C, okay, gamot, supply, food, groceries, and nilulutuan na ng pagkain sila. Every day may mga iba-ibang pagkain dinadala sa kanila. Ganun po tayo in order for us to, our light to shine brighter. If naman sa relationship, kung paano ba mag lumiwanag yung ilaw mo sa relationship, kung may hidwaan, may hatred, may unforgiveness, then it's the time for you to forgive the person. Okay? Or, kung siya naman nakagawa ng ano, ng pagkakamali sa'yo, diba? You forgive and you accept the person. Okay? You impart faith to these people. You encourage them. You share the word of God to them. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, it says, "But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possession, that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light." So that we may proclaim by declaration. Okay? So how can our light shine brighter? It's also by declaration. By sharing the gospel. You know, we have outreaches initiative. Okay, so here in Victoria Antipolo, that despite of this pandemic, you know, the good thing about this is the Word of God, na kahit may pandemic man yan, mahirap man mag-share, actually sa iba-ibang bansa, no, restricted nation, we have to declare the gospel. We have to preach the gospel because the gospel, the light, Jesus Himself as the light of our lives enables us to preach the gospel. In Philippians chapter, actually itong outreach initiative natin, okay, kahit restricted or kahit mahirap, kahit may COVID, the Word of God na preach. Okay, marami pong na-share ng one-to-one. Okay, ito pong nakikita niyo sa picture, may mga PPE tayong ibinigay, okay, may mga outreach tayong ginawa, and then we are able to preach the gospel. You know, the gospel of God is unstoppable. No one can stop the very Word of God. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 14 to 15, do all things without grumbling or disputing, that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God without blemish in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation. So, maaaring may pinagdadaanan ka, di ba, sa paligid mo. So, we're hoping that we are not part of the society na kung saan hindi nag-honor kay Lord, but we would be able to be blameless or righteous and holy before the presence of our God, among whom you shine as light in the world. Okay? So, that's so important na yung light natin will continue to shine. Okay? Yung light natin will continue to shine to those people, to the people around us. Again, we can, yung light natin will shine brighter as we continue to demonstrate who Jesus is in our lives and by declaring the gospel, by proclaiming it, by sharing, okay, by sending a message, by praying to these people and encouraging them that Jesus is the light. Pag may ilaw po, merong hope. Pag may liwanag, merong pag-asa. You know, Jesus is the light of men, and this light can be rejected or believed in. So, whether you like it or not, Jesus is the light of men. Jesus is the light of men. So, you can reject it or you can believe to Jesus. But those who believe are made children of God. You know, as believers who have experienced the life and the light of Jesus, we are called to witness, to share the gospel, to live a righteous life, okay, to run away from darkness, and to continuously follow who Jesus is in our lives, and to be a light to the world so that people, many people, will know who Jesus is as well, kung sino si Jesus sa buhay natin, and would be able to share and preach to them, and that they themselves would be able to have an encounter with God as well and receive Jesus as Lord and Savior in their lives. Can we just bow our heads and let us pray? Lord, thank you that indeed you are the light of men, and it exposes, God, kung sino talaga kami. And thank you, Lord, that you cannot be extinguished, Lord. No one can, Lord, even darkness cannot stop you from shining. And Lord, those who trust in you, Lord, makakayanan na mamuhay, Lord, na faithful, na righteous, and holy. Lord, we pray that all the more we'd be able to follow you. Na kahit mahirap ang buhay, and yet we will not compromise, but we'll continue to believe you, but we'll continue to follow you. And as well, God, you given us, Lord, the ministry. That's the ministry of reconciliation, to reconcile the world to the Father by receiving Jesus as Lord and Savior. The ministry of reconciliation, reconciling the world. Us, Lord, to those people na hindi pa nakakakilala sa inyo, Panginoon, salamat dahil gagamitin mo ang bawat isa sa amin. Lord, thank you, God, for this time. Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful opportunity that you have given to us, that despite of this pandemic that we are facing, Lord, you will use us to be the light also to those people around us, so that many will believe that you are the Christ, you are our Savior. And I would like to pray for two kinds of prayer, two groups of people. The first one is, if you receive Jesus as Lord and Savior and yet you are still in struggling in the dark, may situation sa buhay mo na sobrang nahihirapan kang ma-overcome. It might be unforgiveness, it might be sin issue, it might be relationships na pilit mong ipinaglalaban pero hindi naman talaga dapat ipaglaban. Kasi alam mo na mali. Kasi alam mo na hindi tama kay Lord. There's some area or areas in your life na hindi honorable kay Lord. This is the time for you to really ask the grace of our God to shine in that dark place of your life so that you can have the strength to overcome. And I would like to pray for you. If that is you, I just want to pray for you. Lord, I thank you for my brothers and my sisters for watching right now, attending this online worship service. Lord, I pray that you will minister to them. Lord, I pray that your light will shine brighter to the area of their lives na sobrang madilim, Lord. Bigyan mo ng ilaw. Lord, bigyan mo ng direction, ng purpose, ng meaning, Lord, itong area na to na sobrang madilim sa kanila. Lord, I also pray that you will restore them back to you. That you will bring healing, you will bring strength, you will bring restoration, oh God. And thank you, God, that you will give them the courage to overcome and to walk in the righteousness that you have given to each one of them. Lord, I just lift them up to you. Lord, I speak grace, grace upon grace to be with our brothers and our sisters. Thank you, God, because they are victorious. We are victorious, God, because, Lord, you are the life that gives light to every one of us who believe. And that light cannot be overcome by darkness, cannot be defeated. Thank you, God, because you've called us to be your sons and daughters into you. In Jesus' name. And there's one more thing I would like to pray. If you've never given your life to the Lord, receive Jesus as Lord and Savior. If you've never done that before, I would like to pray for you and give you this opportunity to receive Jesus as Lord and Savior. Okay, to have a personal relationship with God by receiving Jesus as Lord and Savior. And if that is you, you want to make this decision to receive Jesus as Lord and Master of your life, please follow this prayer. Repeat this prayer after me. Heavenly Father, I thank you for sending your Son Jesus to die on the cross for me. I believe that He died for my sins. And I also believe that after 3 days, He rose again from the grave, proving that He is the Son of God. Lord, I am opening my heart before you and coming before you, Lord, and repenting of all the sins that I have done. Lord, I'm sorry for my sins and I repent. And I'm opening my heart, Lord, to receive you as my Lord, my Master, and my Savior. Help me, God, to follow you, to serve you, to know you for the rest of my life. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right, there's two things I would like for you to do. If that is you, you receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. The first one is continue to connect with God. Okay, read the Bible. and ask the person or someone who invited you to watch, okay, and to do one-to-one with you, to journey with you, ano ba itong one-to-one, and also to connect with us. Okay, we want to connect with you. We want to really get to know you all the more. Send a message, and we'd love to connect with you. Okay? So, again, can we just pray right now as we end this online worship service? Can we just lift our hand wherever you are? Lift your hand to God and let us pray. Lord, thank you, God, for your word. That your word illuminates, Lord, yung mga maaring area sa buhay namin na kailangan ng light mo. And we pray, God, that we would be able, again, Lord, to live a life that is honorable to you, pleasing to you. Thank you, God, for your goodness. Thank you for your faithfulness. We honor you, God. We magnify you, Lord. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace, now and forevermore. All right. God bless everyone. See you again next week.